But the real story is right at the top. The number three from Corvette Racing for Antonio Garcia and Jan Magnussen. Calvin?
Well, after four consecutive wins, but then two races off the podium, the number three Corvette needed a routine weekend. Saturday morning practice, damp racetrack. You can see the Aston Martin there laying down some fluid. First up, Porsche driver Richard Lietz loses control in turn three. Wet grass, heavy impact with the tyre barrier. Shouldn't have been a big deal, but just moments later, here comes Jan Magnussen. Same problem, spins off the racetrack and then slams into the side of that Porsche. Wow, what a moment. Huge impact between the race cars, and more significantly, both drivers were injured.
And what happened next was a remarkable flurry of activity by both the Porsche team and the Corvette team as they set about rebuilding two completely destroyed race cars. The Corvette team got theirs done first and actually made qualifying. The Porsche was too badly hurt and needed a tub. It was fixed, and they will both race today.
Now with more on the Corvette story, down to Chris Neville.
Well, Bob, our GTLM points leader, Jan Magnussen, was treated and released yesterday. How was that? It was not cleared to race today. And after speaking with Corvette Racing, it's their safety protocol that says a driver who has experienced a concussive event has to sit out the next day. And because of his radio communication and response after the impact, Corvette Racing has determined that this falls under those guidelines. Jan will go through impact concussion testing later this week and expect him to be back behind the wheel Dakota in a couple weeks. GM factory driver Jordan Taylor was at the track this weekend, and he will replace Jan Magnussen. And while Magnussen is no longer in a position to compete for this championship, Antonio Garcia still very much in it. He's going to need some help from Jordan Taylor today. For more on the Porsche side of the story, Jamie Howe.
Well, Chris, it was Richard Leitz behind the wheel of the number 911 Porsche from Porsche North America. He was sent to a local hospital and treated for an upper arm fracture. He's now on his way home to Austria, where he will receive surgery later this week. The car, however, could not be repaired. Luckily, though, they did have a chassis on site, complete with brand new components. It will race today with the engine and gearbox from the original car. I spoke with the team, and they said Michael Christensen will be starting the number 912, his original car. He will then get behind the wheel of the number 911.
The two Corvettes run nose to tail. Oliver Gavin of the four leading Jordan Taylor. In for Jan Magnussen, the number three. Jamie Howe is standing by with Jan.
The fact that Jan had to take himself out of championship contention in order to look after his health. Jan, first off, how are you feeling today?
I feel fine today. Already last night I started feeling a lot better, but you know, right after the accident, I wasn't feeling so well, and so the decision was made because of that, not to let me race.
As a racing driver in the championship lead, how difficult of a decision was that for you to make?
Well, you know, it wasn't my decision, but I agree with the decision. I did take a hard hit to the head, so for sure it's the right decision, but it's tough to sit here and watch it all slip away. But, you know, we have the manufacturer championship and the team championship that we're going to try and, that I'm going to try and help win. And obviously do everything I can to make sure Antonio gets the driver's championship.
And Jan mentioned that hard hit that he took to the head, but take a look at this. This is the crash box. It's on the side of the car. It should be perfectly pristine like it is here. This is where the point of impact occurred on the car. This is made of Kevlar, and this saved Jan from any further injury. Also, this data recorder was on the side of the car as well. This is made of billet aluminum. This thing should not be able to look crushed. It looks like somebody just squeezed it right in their hand. It was a very hard hit.
Well, here's another look at the impact. Jan Magnussen, we flew it on the racetrack.
Yeah, it's just a vicious hit. That hole in the side of that, that's a bulletproof case, and it's got a hole in it, so it gives you a little bit of the idea of the magnitude of that.
Well, I thought to see that data recorder, I wonder if they're going to be able to recover information about
it. They did. It was a 16G hit with a 7G lateral, so it was a really big impact.
Wow, it was huge. But I tell you what, hats off to Jordan Taylor being drafted in here. He's obviously run with the Corvette team before.
For our cameras, how the Corvette gave it up to save its driver.
You know, race fans come to the racetrack and they watch the drivers and crew in action. They watch the choreography, the footwork, all the concentration that we spend in pit lane, executing perfect pit stops, leading to victory. What they don't see is what takes place behind the scenes when we have a catastrophic occurrence like we did yesterday at Virginia International Raceway. We took a race car that was virtually totaled and a terrific crash here during practice session. We started having to replace a myriad of parts. You can see as we move around the car, all the body work that was entailed. But I think most important, the thing that allowed Jan to walk away was our GM designed crash box. You can see this piece is designed to absorb energy impact, prevent that from being transferred to the driver. It bolts to the existing roll cage. It's filled with an expanded aluminum honeycomb material, carbon fiber wrapped in Kevlar, literally bulletproof. It's pieces like this that allow our drivers to walk away from incidents like we saw yesterday. Our crew performs, our driver performs, and Chevrolet Safety takes care of the rest.